He ain't put nobody on. Be what you gonna be, but put your people on. Put somebody on. Or don't be wondering why people keep saying gatekeepers. Because clearly, y'all are keeping these gates.
And this is why Kai Cenat is the worst person on Twitch. Now, I know a lot of fanboys are going to be upset with me, but just hear me out. Kai Cenat is the number one most subscribed streamer on Twitch. Right now, he might be in the second spot, third spot, whatever. He's in the top three always, and he's typically in the number one spot. In the top 20 of most subscribed streamers, maybe even the top 50, I believe, he is the one and only black person. In the top 100, he's one of four. The other three being his close personal friends. Overnight, he could change the entire streaming community. He could give people opportunities that they never would have seen before. And as a black man, how do you not feel compelled to be like, you know what? It was hard for me to get to this point, so I should probably make it so nobody else has to deal with that problem. Now, me personally, I'm gonna work my hardest to get to that point. And once I do get to that point, I plan on making a whole different type of infrastructure, something like a NBA or NFL draft for people who are good content creators. And I'm gonna figure that whole thing out. But that's not what I'm asking him to do. I'm just wondering why, after you finish streaming, because he streams every single day to hundreds of thousands of viewers, why after you finish streaming would you only want to raid other big streamers? Because he can get something from them. If he raids them, then maybe their viewers will come over to his stream next time. Oh man, I saw you went and raided XQC. Oh, so now I'm over at your stream. But if he goes and raids a smaller streamer, oh, my people might go watch this person, never come back, and I lose that sub money. And if you don't believe all they care about is the money, then ask him. Hey Kai, why won't you raid smaller streamers? Every day after you finish streaming, you could be given an opportunity to another young black streamer, somebody who might be good at entertaining, but not getting the opportunity just because people don't like their skin color. He's either gonna block you or just skip past the question entirely. If you idolize, respect, or even follow anybody in the top 10 on Twitch, ask yourself that. How much do they really care about you or the smaller people who make this stuff happen for them? It's all a paycheck and it's all they care about. Pettigan, what have you done for anybody? I've given 78 people Twitch affiliate. More than half were black and I'm still broke and living in the hood. Meanwhile, your mans has millions.
Well, what about when Kai, he went and gave out those PlayStations and Xboxes?
Have you ever heard the phrase, teach a man to fish? Instead of giving out little trinkets that'll not do anything, give them the opportunity to truly make something for themselves, and they might be able to make something way beyond whatever price point you could have given them. And that's not even mentioning the fact that he's a millionaire, so he could literally go around gifting subs left and right if he so chose. But I'm not even talking about his money. Keep your money in your pocket, right? Go ahead, spend it on all the stupid stuff that you did renting out of prison to do stupid video stuff. I know that he grew up in the suburbs, so things are different, but it still isn't easy for a black man in America, regardless of where you grew up. So I can't imagine why you wouldn't want to make those opportunities for somebody else.
Well, what about Jinxie, XQC, and Nick Merckx, and all the other people in the top 10?
They are equally bad people, and the same thing goes for them. But I'm speaking to Kai because I'm a black man talking to another black man. Save that for the streamers in their community.